Vas-y, Maris, c'est rien.
Maris, what are you doing out here?
I want to give Miriam a knife. Maybe you come with me?
Of course. What is keeping you?
I am nervous.
I am certain she will love the blade you made for her.
What am I doing? Giving a woman a knife as a gift? It's so stupid.
This is something she will appreciate and use.
Ugh. I made the stupid thing. I might as well give it to her.
But where?
Hello, Miriam.
Hello, Norris. Hello, Connor. I'd love to stay and chat, but I promised Ellen a bale of furs this week, and I'm not even close to making good. I need to get out into the bush right away.
Two hunters are better than one. I can help if you like.
Would you? I'd be much obliged.
I bring something for you. Maybe it will help.
I really must get moving. I will thank you properly when I get back. Until then, meet me at my northernmost hunting blind after you take your first skin.
Yama.
Time for forgiveness has passed.
I'll never come back.
Lickspittle might have gutted me.
A timely gift from Norris, it would seem.
Indeed. I must make sure to thank him properly.
Thank you.
Connor! Connor! Ellen's dullard of a man is trying to break down her door with his maids. We're on our way to stop it.
Ellen and Maria are free of you. I say so. The people behind me say so. Believe me when I tell you, if I ever see you on this land again, I will end you.
You can have them.
Thank you, all of you. Nobody has ever stood up for us before.
We protect our own, Ellen.
This is my home now. I'll find a way to show my gratitude to you all. I promise.
Got time to lend me a hand?
My friend!
Norris, what are you doing?
She said yes!
Marion?
We are getting married!
I told you not to touch him, Norris.
Is it true?
Yes.
So now that you've been told, might I have a word? We have much work to do.
Of course. What would you have me do?
Accompany me to the inn. I have business there. Norris is a stickler when it comes to tradition. Miriam knows not where her father is. And they were hopeful that you might act his part at the ceremony.
I am not familiar with colonial wedding customs.
It means you will walk with her during the ceremony and give her to Norris as her father.
I would be honored.
Wonderful. On to other business. Our weddings are complex beasts and require many hands working together to execute. We'll need Warren and Prudence to provide food, Ellen to make them appropriate clothes, Big Dave to smith wedding bands, me to conduct the service, and Oliver and Corinne to host a banquet.
That is a lot.
We'll start here.
You should be.
Connor.
Everything seems to be in order for the big day.
It is. Except, I can't find Miriam.
I'm certain she's making sure all is perfect. I will find her, my friend.
Why do you run?
Leave me be. I'm no housewife.
Nobody thinks you are one.
That's what all this means.
You may kiss your bride.
And my little brother Joseph tossed him in the river.
Connor, we were just recalling our weddings.
Spirited events, I take it.
Spirited? More like brawls than unions they were.
Calling Joe Little is like calling me Big Terry. Boy's a bloody mountain.
My younger brother had a blow-up with one of Terry's cousins. A minor disagreement about some lass's dance card. I'll just say Terry's cousin sobered up right quick when it was over.
Poor boy. Sitting there sopping wet on a stump while Joseph spun around with the object of his affection.
It was good for him. Taught him good things don't come easy.
Connor, enjoying yourself?
I am. It is nice to see everyone together and happy.
Look at those two kids. It's a lovely sight. Norris is one of my best friends, and he couldn't have found a better woman. Proud of him.
Sometimes people are just right for one another. Norris and Miriam are a match made in heaven.
Or a match made by Connor. Isn't that right?
I only helped Norris muster his courage. The rest came naturally.
Excuse me, everyone. Thank you. I won't keep you long. I would like to present something to Connor and you all. I once said I'd find a way to show my gratitude for your courageous actions in my defense. And this is what I give you today. This flag is a symbol of our strength and unity. And I would hope you'd all be proud to fly it high above your homes and shops. I'll happily make one for each and every one of you, if you so desire. But this one is for you, Connor.
Thank you.